We're on our way to an undisclosed secret location, escorted by Sony Computer Entertainment Security, to meet the newest member of the PlayStation family. With the formal announcement at this year's E3, everyone wants to get their hands on the new PSP Go. And that's exactly what we're gonna do. We just don't know where yet. Nice suit.
Over here. Veronica, glad you could make it. Thanks for coming, have a seat. I think there's something here you might want to take a look at.
Is all that really necessary?
We've got top secret information, are you ready?
I am. Welcome to Mama. Wow, it's so tiny, it's so much smaller. But wait a second, where is everything?
Try sliding. That's how you play the game.
I get it now. So fill me in, what's this all about?
So this is our newest PSP. It's called the PSP Go.
All right, so I want the nitty gritty tech specs on this baby.
No problem.
Down and dirty.
So it's a 3.8 inch screen. It's 43% lighter than the PSP 3000. 16 gigs flash memory, Bluetooth support, and all digital content. So the UMD drive goes away. So it's gonna be, I think, something that a lot of consumers are gonna really like, being able to just download straight to a hard drive. The memory stick micro, so that you can add extra memory to it if you'd like. Again, there's no excuse. If you run out of space here, you have a lot of content. So it'll be something that the digitally savvy consumer is gonna really enjoy.
We'll set it right down here between the two of us. So tell me more about the digital content. I mean, is it mainly going to be games, or are there going to be TVs and TV shows and movies as well?
Yeah, so there'll be a mixture. So, you know, a lot of the emphasis will be on games, and I think a lot of the people buying it initially will say, I just want to buy games, and there's games like Gran Turismo that are being announced at E3, and Little Big Planet we announced before, and Jak and Daxter, and there's even a new Metal Gear Solid coming. So all of those games will be available. But then there's movies, and all the first-run movies that you can rent or buy through the PlayStation Network, and TV shows, as you mentioned, as well. So you can bring so much content over with you and fill it up on that 16 gigs flash memory.
Well, since it is called the PSP Go, I imagine it would work with remote play as well.
Integration with PS3 is very important to us, and it works just like PSP 3000, and that's a growing use. A lot of people like to be able to take their content from the PS3 with them on the go.
What are the main differences between this and the PSP 3000?
The first is the onboard memory, the flash memory, 16 gigs of space. There's Bluetooth support as well, so if you have a Bluetooth headset, you can actually tether it to your cell phone as well. But ultimately, it's the portability and bringing that content with you in a smaller form factor. You've got the most immersive games on the PSP platform anyway. Now you've got a smaller unit to do it with.
Is this going to replace the PSP 3000, or can you still get one of those if you want to?
It won't replace the 3000. We're going to keep them both on the market. So if you're a consumer and you say, you know what, I really like tangible products, I like the disc, you can go out and get the 3000 and purchase UMD discs and movies and games with that. If you like digital and ease of use and kind of a more premium nature, the PSP goes for you.
Does the design open up any new opportunities for developers?
If you're a developer, you could say, you know what, maybe I want to create a smaller package, a game that's a little bit easier to play on the go. Maybe something that you'd play for 10, 15 minutes and then put down. Just kind of break up the game a little bit more. So developers, I think, are going to be looking at that. In the initial launch, we're going to have some pretty similar games between the two, but I think longer term, you'll see some changes.
There have been a lot of rumors about the future of the PSP, and this device in particular has been very cloaked in secrecy for the past few months. Why this? Why now?
Well, I think it's relevant. I think in this particular case, we always look to push innovation. For us, we wanted to get into digital and really kind of meet the needs of our consumer. More and more consumers are going online to purchase music, and they're starting to purchase games, and they're purchasing some movies. We always want to be ahead of that curve. We look at each of our products as 10-year lifecycle products, so this needs to live on. Our view of the world is, you know, digital is going to become more and more important as we go along here, and ease of use factors make it that much more important.
Does it speak to Sony's long-term strategy to have downloadable content as opposed to hard media?
We're going to look at a kind of a shared strategy there, actually. Hard media tangible goods have their place, and I think that many consumers say, you know what, I'd really like to be able to just hold that disc. But there's certainly a growing segment culturally that want to be able to have digital goods. They've grown up with being able to download movies and music, and now they can download games.
This is clearly the start of something really cool with the PSP Go. Where do you see it going in the future?
There's a lot of back-end service and support that we'll be putting against it that I think will really excite the base. There's obviously all the games that are coming from discs that'll be available on PlayStation Network, but it's also new IP, new product, new games that are available, you know, only for download. Our focus is really on working with developers, ensuring that they look at the usage model for the Go, and then looking at the services that are going to be available and kind of accentuating those services for how someone would use Go.
When are we going to see this available?
I think a lot of people have been asking about when it's going to come and when we're going to actually make our push towards digital. So it is finally here. It's coming this fall. We think it's going to be a huge product for us.
Am I looking at the only one in existence right now?
Actually, got a second one.
Well, well, well.
Put Gran Turismo on there for you.
Core viewers know I'm not very good at driving games, but I'll give it a go.
Good, let's play.